Between Sharknadoes, The Meg, and Jaws, it's no wonder many of us are afraid of sharks. But much of this fear is unwarranted. For example, an estimated 235,000 Americans are injured every year in their own bathrooms. Meanwhile, in 2018, sharks were responsible for just 32 injuries in U.S. waters. That's not to say a shark encounter can't be dangerous, but sharks aren't the monsters popular culture has made them out to be. In fact, sharks have a better reason to fear humans than we have to fear them. For every one person killed by a shark, about 2 million sharks are killed by people.
Sharks have survived several mass extinctions, but they're being fished right now past their ability to reproduce and replenish the populations.
Marine conservationist and National Geographic explorer Jess Cramp is working to build a better future for sharks and the marine environment.
We were really in trouble of losing some species in my lifetime to overfishing and habitat degradation. When sharks have been removed from certain ecosystems, you have an explosion of the other predators, and this can wreak havoc on reefs and on the balance of the ecosystem.
With more than 500 species of sharks living throughout all of Earth's oceans, the loss of even one of these top predator species would have a profound impact on the ocean's ecosystem. And so, in 2011, Jess co-championed a grassroots campaign to create a gigantic shark sanctuary.
We were successful in securing a 2 million square kilometer shark sanctuary in the Cook Islands.
The shark sanctuary is one of the largest in the world. It protects an area nearly the size of Mexico. And now, Jess is researching shark protection in the Pacific Ocean and around the globe.
Unless we understand where they go and what habitats they're using, it's really difficult to design policies to protect them. The goal today is to catch Galapagos sharks. We're going to implant some acoustic tags and find out where they're going. Sharks have a bad rap. One of my goals is to try to rebrand sharks in a way that's a bit more realistic. They're not man-eaters, but they're also not cuddly teddy bears. Truth is, they are predators, just as we are, and they need to be respected. I 100% believe that there is positive change coming for the ocean in our future. And when we connect with something, it gives us the ability to understand it better and then want to protect it.